Hi there, and welcome back to the Topic Tuesday from the Exilva blog. Today, I'm joined by my colleague Otto, and we're going to elaborate slightly on our favorite subject, the rheology behavior of cellulose fibrils. As you may know, or not know at this point, the cellulose fibrils is what we call shear thinning. And the shear thinning behavior is really something looking like this, where you have viscosity, and you have shear, and the cellulose fibrils, they act in this way, meaning that it will get thinner when you apply shear. So Otto, we were talking a little bit about this and this shear thinning behavior. You brought some practical examples for us today which could sort of show us why the Exilva is shear thinning, or how it is shear thinning, and how you can easily spray this. So could we take a look at what we brought today?
Yeah, I think that if we start from the 2%, and when you look at the sample, it's extremely thick. So of course the first question is that are you able even to use this product?
Exactly.
But when we have this normal spray bottle, which you can use for fixing your hair,
yeah,
or something like that, we have the same 2% here, and then we start maybe this way.
Yeah, we can try it this way.
So you're actually able to spray it easily, just by using the force from the pump.
Great. So that's the behavior you're seeing here, that you have this very high viscosity when the product is resting, but then when you want to apply it, it can easily flow as long as you have shear present.
Yeah, exactly. And then of course it enables you to stabilize heavy particles, whatever things, even you're able to stabilize emulsions.
So high solid systems, for instance, here is very interesting.
Exactly.
But relating to, for instance, current non-technologies, do you have an example of a different type of shear curve?
So for example, Xanthan. So if we make the same concentration, so for example 0.5% of Exilva, 0.5% of Xanthan. So actually Xanthan behaves more or less this, that you have the plateau first,
right,
and then it starts following.
Right.
So actually in this region the behavior is more or less the same.
Yeah.
But on this region you have a much higher viscosity with Exilva.
So this is where you see differences on, for instance, the ability to stabilize higher solid systems with a lot of particles where they don't have this plateau then.
Yeah, exactly.
All right.
And then you can think about that if you want to reach the same viscosity at rest with Xanthan,
yeah,
you are basically going here and then you would be something like this.
All right.
Which makes it probably even non-sprayable.
Right. Well, that's interesting. Very, very interesting. So this enables them to apply these products with high shear on a sprayable. But can you also use other type of equipment to apply the products?
Yeah, of course. And I think one of the key factors is also that how you are able to process the product. So you think about the pumping and process-wise.
Right.
So this enables you to pump, mix, process really thick formulations.
Perfect. So actually, even though it seems very high viscosity, it's easy to handle in the process if you have the right equipment.
Yeah, exactly.
This is a very interesting concept, and this is a sneak preview. But if you download our rheology book, which will be online, and it's online for you guys, you will be able to read much more in detail on the subject, and also to elaborate a little bit more on this shear thinning behavior.